Hey, this is Justin Bryant with Two Notes Audio Engineering. I'm in beautiful Fort Wayne, Indiana at Sweetwater, and I'm super excited to get to show off our new ReVolt series pedals. So we released the ReVolt series earlier at the NAMM show, and now we have them out, and we're very excited for you to be able to check them out. These are new for us. We did have a former Preamp series before that had a clean, a crunch, and a lead pedal, and I didn't want people to think that these are those pedals just crammed in one box. This is actually completely new architecture. We did borrow some things that we really liked about the previous series. It does run at 200 volts. It does have a true preamp tube that's doing a lot of heavy lifting, but these are completely new, designed from the ground up on a whole new architecture. So when we designed the new Preamp series, we knew that they had to be very easy to use. They had to sound exceptional, but they also had to have a pro set of features. These include things like an effects loop. They have full MIDI implementation. They have a direct compensated output, and then they have some special features in the front. The first one is we have a four cable method, and what that does is it allows you to add three channels with assignable boost to your current guitar amplifier. So for instance, if you had a Marshall Plexi or a Marshall 800 that has an effects loop, you now can turn that into a four channel amplifier by still using the amp's preamp. And then even more important are things like the aux in. So if you want to plug your music player into there, it's got an eighth inch input. And probably the most requested and overlooked feature is a headphone jack. So you can plug your headphones in and have a great experience just right out of the box. So we added three channels that are discrete, but play very well together. It's very challenging to build a multi-voiced preamp or analog amp sim or even amplifier where you have three radically different preamp architectures that work well together. So we took as our basis for this is we have the American Clean, which is based off a Fender Bassman that we modeled in France. We have a Marshall Plexi, which we call our British Crunch. And the interesting thing is up till about 10 on the gain knob, it's very much that standard Plexi sound, but then anything past about 10 o'clock, we get into what I would call the hot rutted Plexi sound. And then on top of that, our modern lead channel was voiced after a Soldano SLO-100. So we're on the American Clean channel, and I've got the gain at about 2 o'clock, the volume up just enough to level match all the channels. The treble is just slightly past noon, and the bass is right at noon. And then we can engage the boost by double tapping the button, and that's the amount of boost we can send in there, and we can get this really nice and crunchy. And then on the British Crunch, we'll start with it kind of like a Plexi would be cranked. We'll add in the boost. And then on the modern lead channel, we have the same assignable boost. So without boost. We wanted to make sure that people understood that we know a lot of people use this as a standalone device. And it is. You can plug headphones into it, you could plug it into your recording desk, you could plug it into your DAW, and it's a self-contained system. You could put effects in the effects loop. And speaking of, we have some nice features, what we'll call the pro features, which is MIDI in and out. So this is a full end-to-end MIDI type of system. It's very simple to use, but you can use this to control other devices. You can have other devices control this. So if you had a system that's also MIDI and you want to be able to get a lot of different varieties and flavors, it's all baked in right here. You may have heard in the other clip some delay and things like that ringing out. What I was doing is I'm using the H9 and I'm using the effects loop, but I also have this MIDI out controlling the channels of this. So to go quickly back on the first channel, I'm So if you saw what was going on here, every time I'll change a button, I'm actually sending MIDI channel changes. And things like the rotary, you can see it's deactivated because I have it set to do that. So this is controlling right there. And that's a complete solution right there. And you can see this is a teeny tiny little package. So I've got the ReVolt. I'm going into the Eventide H9, which we're using the MIDI commands. It's in the effects loop of the ReVolt. And then I'm using the cab M only for the DynIR cab. There's no other kind of modeling or anything. So the heart of everything's right in that box. We wanted this to be a complete all-in-one solution. And you'll notice something very handy back here is a direct output. That direct output can be no cabinet, or it can be the cabinet, which is an analog filter, but it sounds really good. And it's based off a Marshall cabinet with vintage 30s. And that's, again, it's assignable or not. So if you want to run it into your DAW without cabinets and use our DynIRs, then great, or other third-party IRs, you can do that. But if you want to make it as a self-contained solution, we have that built in right for you. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention a super cool feature of what the four cable method does. Basically, it takes any amp with an effects loop, and you can add three extra channels plus the boost, so you can add three completely new channels to any amplifier. So for demonstration purposes, our friends at Victory were using this Victory Super Kraken, and I just have the amp set on the first channel with some nice crunch to it. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add in our three channels on top of it, so you can see that you get three unique voices, but they blend perfectly together. Thanks so much for watching. This is Justin Bryant from Two Notes Audio Engineering. If you have any questions about the ReVolt G Series pedal, don't hesitate to contact your Sweetwater sales engineer or go to sweetwater.com.